With MicroStrategy Web, you can easily add interactivity between datasets in your dashboard by configuring selectors. Selectors let you filter data based on selections you make. With Esri Maps for MicroStrategy, you can configure a layer on the map as a selector, which allows you to make selections on the map to dynamically update other datasets in the dashboard. You can also configure a layer on the map as a target of a selector, which lets you make selections in other datasets to update the layer. Configuring a map layer as a target of a selector will be shown later in the video. This dashboard contains three datasets. One is a map showing customer revenue by state. The second is a bar chart showing profits by customer region. The third is a grid showing revenue and profits for customer states. You can now configure the selection of customer states on the map to trigger changes to the profit data shown in the bar chart. To do this, the state's map layer must be configured as a selector. Start by switching to design mode. The Esri globe icon indicates that this grid has been configured as a map widget. The grid represents the states layer that you want to use as a selector. Right-click the customer state column of the map grid and choose Use as Selector. Now specify your target. Esri Maps for MicroStrategy lets you specify one or more targets, including other maps in the dashboard. In this video, you will specify just one target. Select the bar chart grid, Region Cost and Profits, and add it to the selected targets list. Click Create to create the selector. Now that you have configured the states layer as a selector and specified the bar chart as the target, you can return to interactive mode to interact with the dashboard. Using one of the drawing tools, select states from the states layer. Click the rectangle selection tool and draw a rectangle to select some states on the East Coast. Notice that the bar chart is updated to show profit data for only the states you selected. To return the bar chart to its original state, click the clear selection icon. Your selection on the map is also cleared. A similar workflow can be used to configure a layer on the map as a target of a selector, to dynamically trigger an update to the map based on a selection in the revenue and profit grid. First, return to design mode. Next, right-click the customer state column of the revenue and profit grid and choose Use a Selector. Now specify the grid representing the layer you are targeting, and set an additional option to allow the selection to be reset to show all states when the customer state column heading is selected in the grid. Select the Show Option for All checkbox and click Create. The revenue and profit grid has been configured as a selector, with the map as the target. Now you can return to interactive mode to try the selector configuration. When you select Alabama in the revenue and profit grid, the state of Alabama is selected on the map. Now, to reset the selection to display all the states in the map, click the Customer State heading. You can also have the map automatically zoom to a selected state. In the Contents pane, display the settings for the layer and turn on Zoom on Load. Now when you select California in the grid, the state of California is selected on the map and the map zooms in to California.